burnt out guy here, and welcome back. Alright, so we're doing a little bit of Netherwinter. Now, I did go ahead and try to do this quest. My capture card kind of acted up because of my PC there, my laptop. It's on the verge, you know, like, but I'm doing my best here. Like, now it's working fine, so I'm going to take advantage of it, like, you know, recording properly. But we're having issues, but that's only because of, like, it's a crappy PC. But anyways, it's all good. So now the quest that we're working on goes along with the campaign, all right? This is something we were working on prior to me stopping, and then now I'm coming back, right? So blah, blah, blah. So now in the order... The Bending Order of the Third Eye, we were working on this before, right? So before we weren't able to do this because we needed a certain quest, and the quest that we were working on was Searching the Present. Now, in order to finish Searching of the Present, before I go and I accept all that and continue on, you're going to get this little blue glowing eye in your inventory. Here, let me go and show you where it is. It is going to look like... Where is it? Oh, well, anyways, if you look at my bottom screen in the HUD, you're going to see, like, a bluish-purple kind of with an eyeball-like thing. That is what you're going to get in your inventory. Equip it to your crosshairs, and that way you're going to be able to use it. Now, in this whole area, there is... You have to activate it. So if you press down on the down, you're going to activate this. And then you're going to see that it's going to light up these treasure chests. And these are what you have to collect in order to get the... To get whatever you need to collect. There are 12 documents, if I'm not mistaken. So once you get those 12 documents, and they're... You don't have to venture very far, like, in this little area. Even though they highlight a huge area for you to get them in, you actually get, like, most of them within this first little area of the blue where you're going to be. So once you get that, we end up having to go back to... I believe we have to go back to Prospector's Enclave. But before we do that, we can actually go into the campaign because we completed it, right? So we're going to go and accept it. So I want the bag. Honestly, I want the bag. Bag of holding for me is... I'd rather bag. Possible location on the Staff of Sarvis. Used in quests. Do we get both of these? We only get one. Oh, well. I chose the other one. I chose the bag. I want the bag. I really don't care about a staff. I don't know if that's what I should have taken, but... Whatever. Oh, we get both. Look at that. Awesome. So take rewards. So we get both. So now that we have this completed, something else was supposed to happen. We're supposed to be able to go into... where is it? Here. Wait. Must be in the characters. And then I think it's the boons. Don't we get a boon for this? I think we have to cash it in first, but I think this is the one that it falls under. I'm not 100% sure. But we'll go back, we'll go cash it in, so let's make our way to Prospector's Enclave. Like I said, I'm not 100% sure. As you see, I also went up a level, so I'm not going to do any level gaining at the moment. I have to go find the character build I was using when I was building this character up. I don't want to go and waste my points elsewhere. I'm pretty sure you can... oh, really? You guys, like, super suck. We'll just kick your guys' butt here. Where did you go? Alright, leave my healer alone. You guys really suck. There's a chance I get knocked off again here, too. We'll see. See if I can get away from these guys. Try to get there as fast as possible. I don't want to. Oh, yeah. I had a feeling that was going to happen. Oh, yeah. I aggroed everybody. That's fine. They're pretty easy to dispatch, so. And they're all after my other one here, so. Let's get rid of these guys real quick. Come on. Why are you guys always after my other one? There we go. Take this. And, excellent. Another bunch of stuff here we'll collect. This is mainly stuff to sell, so It doesn't bother me much. Collect a little bit of junk now and then. Now, where are we going here? There's our little blinkly path. That's pretty awesome. I like that little path thing, Pathfinder. That's great. That way you never get really sidetracked from what you're doing. It's pretty awesome. That it is pretty awesome. So let's make our way through here. I hope the video quality has improved a little bit. I've been playing around with certain settings and stuff like that. So, and same with the sound. I've been trying to work on getting rid of a certain humming sound. So, anyways, we're going to go back to Prospector's Enclave here. And we'll go cash this quest in and we'll see what it gives us. Because I'm not 100% sure. Like, I didn't do much research on this game when I started to make videos on it because it was new to me, right? And I like experiencing the new things when it comes to a game. So I don't want to like learn too much about what's going on because then that way, well, it kind of ruins it for me. So I'd rather like, you know, just kind of go with the flow and wing it, right? And learn stuff as I go along. So, but yeah. Off we go. We're going to go cash this wonderful quest in. And it's... Where is it here? It's pretty far up. I wonder if it's that woman in that library. It's a good possibility. No. Come on. Jump. There we go. Excellent. Excellent. There we go. Is it... Oh, it's this guy. Oh, yeah. Alright, so... We'll talk to Sergeant Knox here.
Protectors Enclave needs your help.
Oh, he just gives us quests. But I don't think that's who we have to... Ah. Alright, we'll just accept them.
I have a friend among the priests of Ogma who has been filling me in on some very old and powerful magic items. Artifacts, he calls them. Seems he's learned the resting place of some of these artifacts, and he's afraid that other less desirable researchers may learn the same. Personally, I'd rather have someone like you holding a powerful item rather than some red wizard or dragon cultist. Go talk to Elder Reader Loris at the Sage Shop here in Protector's Enclave. He'll be expecting you.
Alright, so we're gonna go and cash in that. I just wanted to listen to what that person had to say. Sometimes, you know, they have something worthwhile. So this is where we're gonna start getting into the artifact stuff too. I'm not 100% sure how all that kind of stuff works, so we're gonna learn that along the way. If anybody that, you know, like, has experience that watches these videos or whatever, you know, you never know, right? Yeah, I'm a small channel, but you never know. let me know how those artifacts work. I know they're pretty intense. There's a lot of stuff, so let's talk to her. And, what do we get? Some experience and some money? Awesome. Perfect. What do we have here? Do we have anything we can buy from her? Apparently not. Apparently not. Alright, so that finished that. So let's see if we go into our campaigns here. Alright, so it's all completed. Alright, so if we go into the character one, go to boons, there's nothing here that pops up, eh? Oh, that's unfortunate. Very unfortunate. There's nothing. Absolutely nothing. So I really don't know the purpose of all that. I don't know if we got anything really worthwhile. But actually, what is this other thing we got? We did find some kind of a scroll, didn't we? We'll put that, so we'll have another bag going on here. But I'm pretty sure we got some kind of scroll, didn't we? Something that, might have been a quest item, but still. It should be in my inventory somewhere, since I really didn't do anything. This right here, no? Crumbling Dog, Third Eye, no, that's not it. That's my new bag. Useful items. Oh, that's strange, very strange. It must be something to do with a quest related or whatever, but it's all good. So, guilds, I know they want me to join a guild at this point, but that's not kind of our plan at the moment. I want to stay away from joining guilds at the moment. I just want to do the single player kind of let's play, go through this kind of thing. If eventually I decide to get into the whole clan thing, well, that'll be part of a different series, I guess, maybe we'll do after we've completed all the single player missions, right? Aspects of it all. Alright, so I guess we'll go and start choosing our next quest. We're going to take this one. Oh, I don't want that one. So we'll go with the artifacts. We'll start with the artifacts, maybe. Yeah, that sounds like a pretty good idea. Alright, so let's go draw the path. And then... I wonder why it keeps it checked. Oh, well, it doesn't really matter. Alright, so let's go this way. We'll figure out what all these artifacts are for. Maybe I'll do a little bit of research after this video and figure out what all these artifacts are for, because I know I've seen like a lot of videos explaining them and stuff, but I never really did like 100% catch on to what their main purpose was. But we will. We'll have a rundown at this and figure it out. That's not a problem. So these down here in the shop that I remember. Enter the shop. Riding my steed. Alright, so listen to what this person has to say. Artifact.
You are the one Sergeant Knox recommended. He seems most impressed with you. That's good. I need someone I can trust. As a priest of Ogma, god of knowledge, I have spent many years studying wondrous items, as well as lesser and greater artifacts of power. I've learned more than enough to cause me grave concern.
Alright. Artifact
Through
recovery.
Painstaking study, I have discovered where a cache of valuable artifacts was hidden long ago. According to my sources, they can be found deep within the Cragmire Barrows, among the Black Dagger ruins. Recovering these artifacts will be no trivial matter. Their former owner was an accomplished wizard, and he is certain to have prepared a secure resting place for his prized possessions. You can expect formidable guardians as well. Lastly, the artifacts are bound within a magically sealed casket. The defenders of Neverwinter are in need of artifacts like these. If you...
Alright. So, you seen there that one was for movement speed, one was for recovery, and the other one was for critical hits. Now, I'll probably end up taking the critical hit one because I'm kind of going for a DPS build. If I'm not mistaken, anyways, that's what I was going for, was a DPS build. So we'll go and we'll complete this quest here and we'll call it an episode afterwards. That way we can just kind of slowly get back into the things without trying to bite too much off of the cake in one shot here, right? Alright, so I can't do that right now. Why? Very strange. Let's go. Let's adventure. Let's go get this, wherever it is. Oh, why did it go back to the guild one? I don't want that. Journal. Draw path. Alright, so I'm going to have to keep my eye out on for that one, because otherwise it's going to freak me out here. Alright, so we can just turn around from what I gather. Yeah. And then we're off to Black Dagger Ruins. Okay, okay. Let's go to Black Dagger Ruins. And I'm trying to hold off on sending my companion to go and... to go upgrade himself as well. Oops, I think I just ran past him, did I not? Oh, what's this? Really? It wants me to go here? Okay. Whatever. Alright. Oh, I was already in there, wasn't I? Silly me. Alright, so let's see where this wants me to go. Here? Really? Alright, let's follow it. Let's see where it has to go. Oh yeah, look at that. I had no idea. Black Dagger Ruins. That's where we're going. Interesting. It shows that I haven't played this in a very long time. But it's an awesome game. I really enjoyed it. And I'm trying to make these as informal as possible for all of you that are watching. Just because I don't know a lot about the game as well. But from whatever I learn, I will try to share my knowledge with all of you. And I hope these quests do help, you know, if you're, like, stuck anywhere and you see me complete them, you kind of get an idea on on how to do it, right? So, well, yeah. Well, we're going to continue on getting down here. It looks like I can cut through here. Actually, I probably could have cut through the other side. Huh. That's very strange. Enter the Kragmar Borough. I wonder if that is a dungeon, like where you normally have to go. Like, you can just queue those dungeons up. Cause sometimes they are, and you have to go and find stuff in there, but we'll see. We'll see. I'm not going to worry too much about capturing spies, because by the looks of it, the spy thing is going on right now. But, yeah. Alright, so let's jump off the horse. There we go. We can get the lore from that, which is pretty awesome. Alright, so what do we got going on in here? Alright. Nothing here. Alright, let's try to dispatch these people as fast as we can. There we go. Aha! Death to you. I'll probably end up filling myself up with a bunch of junk armor and stuff like that, just to sell. Just because I'm like one of those type of people at the beginning of a game, like until like I amass like a decent fortune, like, and I'm not even 100% sure if it's even worthwhile, the whole gold thing, because everything's all about those Zen coins, eh? So probably later on I'll find ways to farm, end up farming all that. I think they're raw essence or something like that there. These gems or diamonds or whatever they are, and those things you kind of sell, so we'll end up doing stuff like that later on, which I figure is a pretty good idea. Oh, wonderful. Let's try to damage this thing. How am I doing for health? Not bad, not bad. There we go. Let's get rid of that nice and fast. Dungeon kits are always good. Never know when you're going to need them. Oops. Sometimes the red stuff, like, I'll pick up, but, you know, I actually kind of didn't want to pick up. Alrighty, now we're going to go in here to the Forgotten Vault. Had to do a little quick cutout there. Had to go get my son, you know, that time of the week. Got to go get him. Alright, so here we're going to fight a variety of different little battles. So, yeah, every time you click the skull, it's pretty cool, though. Building comes out from the back, which is kind of neat. It's pretty sweet. I like that. Good thought. Alright, so wait for the bridge to get there, because I have fallen off before, and it kind of sucks. You feel like a complete noob. Alright, so let's get rid of these guys. Eventually, I'm assuming that move's going to be worthwhile. Let's get rid of these guys really quick anyways. Some of the guys are a little bit tougher. They're kind of like miniature bosses, I guess, in a sense. But we should be pretty good. We should be pretty good. Oh, there's still more baddies. Let's get rid of these guys. Hey. Well, that was useless. I just attacked midair. Bet you the air felt that. There we go. Now we're doing some damage. There we go. Oh, okay, the other ones are archers. Let's make it over here. Barrel roll. Barrel roll. Alright, good stuff, good stuff. So there's the first wave done. So I think there's like 6 waves or so. I'm gonna just gather all this crap here. Oh, okay, so I must be full then. Alright, so that's kind of a crappy thing if I'm full already. Alright, no, I'm not full. That's fine. It gives me a chance to get rid of some of this crap anyways. Yes, discard. Oops, wrong one. Discard. Yes. Discard. Yes. And discard. We'll just get rid of those ones for now. Make ourselves some more room. Alrighty. Next. Out of sight. It's like right in front of me. What are you talking about? It's out of sight. I'm actually like beside it now. You gotta rub its forehead like a good puppy. Ooh, good skull, good skull. Alright. Let's Let's give her. I think this one's like a titan of some sort, or a golem, or whatever. Yeah. Yes, it was. It was a golem. Let's see if we can get our little power-up thing going on here. Alright, so far the golem's down. It's just this guy left. Didn't even need to use that big power-up. That's pretty awesome. Alright, so here's another one. It's coming along pretty good. Alright, so that's all of them. Must be. The skull hasn't appeared yet, though. Where's the skull? Oh, there's the skull. That's weird. You would have thought it would have been on the other side, right? Out of sight. There we go. Perfect. So it looks like we got our builder back from our profession here. So for the profession, I chose artifacting. I don't really know if there's any bonus to choosing any in particular one, but I'm just going to keep choosing the 6-hour one for a while, mainly because I don't have to constantly micromanage it, and it's just gone for 6 hours, and then that's good enough for me. yeah. Alright. There we go. Now there's only one left. Oh, look at that big guy. Oh, thank you. At least I got out of there in time. And those guys back there are doing some crappy stuff. Let's try to get rid of him first. How's my health? Health is good. Not too bad. Alright, so now we can get rid of these skeletons very quick. There we go, one down. I like that little multi-strike thing. I think that's kind of cool. Alright. Picking up a bunch more junk. Some of it's money, which isn't too bad, but the rest of us will give us money too, the rest of it. So we're getting there, I see we have another one in the distance. So hopefully, we should be nearing the end of this. Don't want to make these videos like too long. I like to stay with under a half hour, you know, for most of my videos. That way, you know, like, it doesn't get too boring to watch. And if you're looking for certain types of information on how to do stuff, well, it'll be good for that, and you won't have to skip around, and you'll be able to view exactly what you wanted to watch, right? Oh, I didn't get out of there in time. Well, that kind of sucks. Alright, so this should make my power up. Come on. Not that it does much damage right now, but... Oh, there we go. He's toast. I'll take that healing potion with pleasure. What's this? More money. So we're up to 3 gold. Oh, ooh. We're rich. We got 3 gold. Alright, so I guess it'd be like equivalent to almost like $3,000 if you want to look at it, because you get like pennies or cents, and then you get dollars, and then you got like bigger dollars. Alright, see what this guy has to say.
One day some person of the night would discover the secret of this forgotten vault and challenge me for possession of the Kratlar family's greatest treasures. By besting my guardians, you have proven your power. Let us now test your knowledge. Tell me, intruder, what was responsible for the destruction of the illustrious noble house of
Oh, geez. Really? I actually have to answer this? Oh, boy. I have no idea. I don't know. It's either the Black Dagger Bandits or a Magical Plague. Oh, which one? Which one? Let's try the Magical Plague. Oh, that wasn't right. Because if it was right, you would... You wouldn't fight anybody. That's fine. No worries. We'll dispatch these things there, no problem. not much of a challenge these guys are. Alright. Perfect. Level 24. So we got 2 points to add in there. I have found the character build while in between these shots for the videos. Which is good. So at the end of the video I'll be able to do that. Alright, so by the looks of it, I think there's only one more. This could be the last one. I'm not 100% sure. Could be the last one by the looks of it. Yeah. Ooh, I found an artifact. Alright, so let's see what this is. A sealed coffer. Alright, excellent. Right on. So now I'm assuming we're going to have to go back to... I believe it's Prospect Enclave, and then we're going to go and cash that in and get our first artifact. I'm probably going to take the critical damage, mainly because I think that would be the best for me, since I'm going for a high DPS build. We're going to go and do that, so I'll make my way over there and do that. So I might cut this part out of the video just because it was, you know, a little long getting over there. Try to keep the videos a little bit short. Alright. Go around these guys. No, I'm not. Oh, you guys suck. You guys had to have archers, didn't you? There. Take that. Was it really worth disturbing me now for? Ugh. Pathetic. Alright. Eventually I'd like to get another animal that has faster speed. But this is technically faster than running. Probably about twice as fast, maybe. Can't see it being much more faster than that. Here, we'll invoke while I'm here. Excellent. Yes, that's where we go. To the Prospector's Enclave. So, now we're back, jump on the horse, we're going to go over here and probably down to that shop on the side again, to that old man, if I'm not mistaken, that's where we go. Yeah, I think that's exactly where we're going. It's pretty good, we're being productive on this first episode. We got quite a bit done actually, so pretty content with that. See how the series kicks off. I know I got a lot of views on some of my other videos. It's probably one of the reasons why I decided to do Neverwinter, because there were some of my videos were a pretty big hit. So I will continue trying to bring this kind of information to everybody. So let's cash this in now. Artifact recovery.
This is indeed the coffer I asked you to find. I have performed a ritual that grants me the power to open these magically sealed containers. Let us see what is within. Behold, 3 powerful artifacts, and as promised, you shall have your choice of them. I advise you to consider your options carefully. This is an
Alright. Now we open the chest, and this is when we get to choose the artifact. So, like I was saying before, one is for movement speed. Creates a portal for a shopkeeper. Oh, you can also get a shopkeeper. Okay. Heals you for 1100 points or 6 seconds. Okay. and deals 235 damage, and enemies increase the damage they take by 10 for 6 seconds. I don't know, this one almost seems kind of worth it, because then you could sell stuff whenever you need to sell stuff, right? I don't know, what do you guys think? I think we should go with the one with the guy that sells the shopkeeper. I don't know. Because this does what? Movement speed? Movement speed's not too bad either, so... screw it, let's go with the shopkeeper. We'll just do it like that. Alright, so we're going to end today's episode there. We've collected our first thingamabobber, our first artifact, I guess, or I think that's an artifact. I'm not really sure 100%. But I know there's also a bunch of stuff in this guy's house you can go and read and all that there for lore. So, but anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video, everybody. Don't forget to like the video and please subscribe. Always wonderful to have more subscribers. So peace, everybody. Take care and we'll see you next time.